My name is Dana Brown. I'm Training Director at Jebco Associates, and I'm owner of Time's Dark Captains. And with me today, I have Calvin with Doggone Mold. And they are a company that's starting to use mold dogs for detecting mold in houses. And I've been teaching mold classes since 2004 through many hurricanes through Florida, the Gulf Coast, everywhere. And I've heard about mold dogs. And this is the first time I've actually got to see and work with a mold dog. And I've had him in here a couple of times, and he works pretty good. And I like dogs, but this particular dog, you have to rub mold all over you, have him play with you. So anyway, can you tell us a little bit about Mason here,
Kelly? Yeah, so Mason was actually owned by a college student, and she unfortunately was not able to properly take care of him, especially due to having to move into dorms. So the company that we go through for dogs actually purchased him from her, so he's technically a rescue dog. They trained him how to detect mold through scent for a company. He is Mason the fifth dog that is in our company. The first Mason is actually retired on the beaches of Florida right now.
So that's good dog.
That's where they end up. So really, it's important to have the dog, because whenever you go through, sometimes you might think that you smell mold, but humans can only detect mold through scent with a 30% accuracy, which is not very high at all. Mm-hmm. Dogs, however, if trained properly, can detect mold with over 90% accuracy, meaning that they're going to be able to find mold in places that I sometimes wouldn't be able to. Mm-hmm. So like, let's say we're going through a house and the baseboard has a crack in it that I might not be able to see through very well. Well, those particulates are so small, they'll still go through there, and Mason can find those through that. Mm-hmm. So it just really helps.
Well, I think when we go through houses and try to find mold and whatever, some of the biggest problems we have is finding the dilute mold throughout a house.
Exactly.
Now, when you get heavy infestations of mold, is Mason a very good tool in houses that are just completely full of mold?
Well, that's where part of it comes into play, is that a big part of our company is making sure the dog is safe. We don't want to put him in unsafe conditions. If we see visible mold, there's no reason to bring Mason into that house at that point, especially if it's a heavy infestation. Yeah.
So where humans would go through, and in most cases, we either have to cut holes in the wall to actually see behind it, mm-hmm. or we'll have to use wall checks, a sampling device, or we'll take air sampling, but the air sampling does not necessarily divulge mm-hmm. what's going on. So, you know, the error rate with humans looking behind walls, I don't know what that is. How good do you think he is on finding mold generally? If he's peak training, he's on it. What do you think?
Probably. So if there's a hole in the wall or any sort of crack or anything that allows the air to flow through, mm-hmm. so the particulates can come out, because that's what he's detecting, is the actual mold particulates in the air.
And the NVOCs.
Exactly.
The gases coming off.
And then he tracks those NVOCs, gases, and mold particulates to that location, and then points at it with his nose. He'll even give it a little scratch. Dogs, they tend to want, whenever they're doing scent, they tend to want to scratch, because they know that whenever they scratch, whatever it is going to go up in the air more, and they can find it more easily. So that's how I know whenever Mason finds something 100%, and I know that I can trust him. So if there's a hole in the wall and there's a lot of mold back there, or even a small amount, there's about over 90% chance, like I was saying, compared to the human's 30% chance of detecting it, which if it was behind the wall, it'd be about 0% chance for us, because we wouldn't be smelling that.
Unless we get into the wall.
Unless we literally stick our face in the wall, yeah.
Now, what's your, you've had five Masons so far?
Yes,
and your success out, how well does he correlate to air samples? Probably not much at all. He's more probably a bulk sample kind of guy, finding a bulk amount.
In Kansas City, they don't do a lot of sampling because the laws are a lot different than in Texas, where you have to confirm or unconfirm. Mm-hmm. And so we really don't have too much of a control on that one at the moment to really have an example of. Though I will say that Mason hasn't found mold in the houses the samples have been low, and he has found mold in the samples that were high, usually whenever it's low. Every once in a while he won't, because it can come from things like an HVAC system, or even something high up like a roof leak or something like that. I'm not picking him up and bringing him up to look at it. Right. That would just confuse him.
Yeah.
Hi, this is Calvin Ladley with Doggone Mold here. This is Mason the Fifth. He's the fifth dog with our company. Right now, I'm going to give you an example of how I usually train him in the morning, beyond just putting samples behind cabinets and such. This is actually what I call the smell board.
I got this idea from the person who actually originally trained him. Basically, these are just PVC pipes in there with holes in them. That way, it's the aerosolizes. It can actually go through that grate, and Mason can pick up on it through there. That way, I can not only train him to find molds that he's already tried before, but I can also have him discover new types of mold that he might not be used to. So, for example, right here, I asked Dana which one of these grates he wanted me to hide the sample in. He chose grate number 2, so now we're about to go through and give you an example of how Mason does his training.
You ready, boy?
Come here.
Check.
Good boy. Check. Find it. Find it. Where's your treat? Where's the treat, buddy? Come on. Oh, good boy.
So if you see, whenever Mason really finds mold, what he'll do is he'll paw at it, and then he'll sit.
Good boy.
So what happens is that Mason is a food type dog. He knows that that association with that mold smell will get him a treat just like that. He'll even do it without me having to tell him. That's what I do in the houses.
Good boy. Come on.
So what I'll do is, I'll bring him away just for a moment behind the closed door. Now make sure he doesn't see, because he'll be real smart and try and get you one over on you. And I'll actually flip the board around. Now Mason can't read these numbers, so that's a good thing. So we bring Mason back in.
Come here, buddy. Check. Find it. Where's the treat? Where's the treat, boy? Come on. Where's the treat? Where is it, boy? Where is it? Find it. Come on. Oh, good boy.
So you have to continue tapping. The reason why is because you don't want to seem like you're signaling him as to where it is. So you keep going from place to place to place, making him almost confused. But he has to find the scent. That's the most important part. And then that food is the reward for finding that scent. Good boy. See, as he does it, he gets better and better and better.
Good job, buddy. Mason, come here. Find it. Find your treat. There you go.
There we go.
There he goes. Good boy. Good boy. Show me again. Show me again. Show me. Good boy. Good boy. Good job, buddy. Who's a good boy? Who's the best boy? Who's the best boy? Come on. One more time. Show me. Come here. On the other side. Come on. Show me. Good boy. Good job, buddy. There you go, it's food.
See if you can bring it up over here.
Come on. Mason, check. Find your treat. Where is it, boy? Where is it? Oh, good boy. Good job, buddy. Good job. Good job. Show me again. Show me again. Show me. Good boy.
Again, this is Mason and Calvin with Doggone Mold, and Doggone Mold has offices in Arlington area.
It's actually the Grand Prairie region.
Grand Prairie.
But that stretches all the way over DFW. Okay. You know, I'll drive an hour out if I have to.
Okay. And then they're also out of Kansas City. That's where the home office is. Have you done much on the tornado damage? And have you worked on any jobs in the tornado area yet?
So I had one job that I got just before the tornado happened.
Right.
But then her power was out, and she just hasn't really called me yet after that.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of it is like the people are just in such distress right now still to this point because of the damage that they're not even thinking about the mold.
Well, now if they had the roof off and all that, Mason probably wouldn't be the applicable school there. He'd be good to come in and go like, oh, nice
puppy. Yeah, just like, hey, man, this house is really broken.
So anyway, well, thank you for coming over today. I appreciate it. And hopefully we'll shoot another video here and put Mason through his paces here.
Excellent.
Thank you. And for the rest of you, farewell. As a disclaimer for this video, I want to let everybody know that at JEBCO Associates and myself, we don't endorse any particular mold consultant or mold remediator. From JEBCO Associates, we basically have done training with mold classes, but the assessment technician level, the assessment consultant, and the remediation contractor level since 2004. We have a lot of our clients who come to us, and we respect them very much. So we really don't, the point of this video is not to really endorse doggone mold. But in my conclusion dealing with the mold dog, I think there are some takeaways with this particular tool that you would use. This particular tool would be good for use in buildings that have hidden mold growth that's very hard to find. There is a large discussion about how mold assessment and mold air sampling is kind of higgledy-piggledy. There is a discussion in air monitoring with mold that is probably not all it's cracked up to be. For instance, we can't really get exposure data unless we take a lot of these small level samples. What it can tell us is if we're trending to cleanliness. It's not going to be exactly the same day to day. And sometimes if we take hidden mold samples, well, we may get mold detected in an air sample, but it's not telling us exactly where it's coming from. So the problem of the dog or using the dog with odor detection is that again, it works. They use these dogs all the time for people bringing in the invasive species into like Hawaii and other places. Then these dogs do work very well. I have seen this, as I said before when I opened up this video, I've seen this in Florida and areas where you had hurricane strikes, and again, these dogs have been, they can find cadavers under the water, for God's sakes. So they can actually, the detection is not the issue. The issue is what does the dog's response. So it's not just the dog, it's also the handler and consistent handling through that whole process on dealing with this. I think in a building that has difficult to address mold by air samples, you couldn't take enough air samples. A properly trained dog that works well with a good handler, with a consistent training process, can give you excellent results. I think they can find mold where we couldn't without cutting open the walls. And again, human beings, you know, you get to the accuracy of human beings, we do not have x-ray vision. They don't have x-ray noses, but they can sense things very, very, very lower than what we can sense. So the big deal is, the biggest issue is interpretation of what that dog's doing. It's the pawing and the marking. And it's best to have a dog that marks, that sets, that just doesn't get their nose down and points. You have to get some kind of training in there that the dog will set and mark. And then that would give you a place you could open up and maybe take a wall check. Now we can do the same thing with wall checks going around exterior walls and chase walls as well. But again, we're hunting and poking too. And the dog can basically, I think, if you have a properly trained dog that's handled properly and consistently trained, I think this can be a addition to the mold industry. Anyway, I found it fascinating. We had the chance to have one of these mold dogs come in, and I was lucky enough to video it. and again, give it to you.